We'll give folks another minute or two to show up. Okay, I think we've got a kind of an interesting agenda today, so let's make an effort to get started here. So first of all, the usual rundown of where we are in the viewer pipeline. It's been a little thin lately, which is a nice change, but that will be changing relatively quickly. So the mesh importer continues to go through cycles of finding and fixing problems, but the problems do seem to be becoming less severe over time. So that will at some point actually get released. We have the maintenance, another batch of maintenance fixes that are working their way through QA and should shortly be out unless they already did go. Let me look. No. Right. But that's coming. And you should see those pretty soon. A little bit smaller than the last batch, but the last batch was unreasonably large. The notifications viewer similarly is has been getting plenty of exercise as a project viewer. Expect a release candidate from that pretty soon. Let me see what else we got here that I want to talk about. So then we've got the graphics quick preferences viewer has been getting some feedback as a project viewer, not as much as I was hoping for. So anybody that wants to give that a try, please do. Trying to get a couple of last few little tweaks to that done. And then I'm hoping to get that out as a release candidate sometime in the next couple of weeks would be my guess. Ones that I didn't put on the agenda, but which, because the developments have been kind of late coming, in the next week or at most two, I expect, I'm sorry you feel that way, Niran. I expect, Chrome Embedded Framework Viewer to be out as a project viewer probably next week. So look for that. Fingers crossed, but there will still be a couple of minor issues to be dealt with before it'll be ready for release candidate, but it will certainly be ready for people to do testing for whatever it is they're using web media for. It will not support QuickTime, and it will not fix Flash on a Mac. It will by default, I believe that the current plan is that we will by default have Flash disabled even on Windows. It may be possible for people to turn that on their own, but it is not something we will consider supported. The standard response to why doesn't my Flash work is go change it to HTML5 video. And then it will work because that does work. Move to the standard, the new standards, and we will all be much better off. So we're pretty excited about that. So be looking for that next week. Hopefully project viewer next week. How long it stays a project viewer depends in part on how many people do some real testing with it and what kind of problems are found. That's coming. Yeah, we probably won't have them say that. But we will have them say, convert your content to HTML5. The other one that we expect to get moving through the pipeline is the HTTP rewrite viewer. This is taking the new HTTP interfaces that Monty did and applied to the most critical components like the texture pipeline and the inventory fetching, have now been replaced throughout the code. And actually the only thing left to do on that viewer at this point before it's ready to go out as a widely used release candidate is to actually delete the old HTTP code out of it. So that's going to be coming. It's a significant rewrite. And yes. But that will be coming. We will probably put out a project viewer, a last project viewer update for that, and then follow it very, very quickly with a release candidate, since functionally there's nothing much new for people to attract people to test it. This is mostly a code cleanup thing. So we will be putting that out, and we'll be putting that out and seeing whether people start reporting problems with it. Again, that one's, it was a heck of a first assignment to give Ryder, and he has pulled it off admirably. So we're really happy with that. Let's see. So that's the viewer pipeline. Questions on viewers? I think that's pretty much, we will get back to doing a Rift update at some point, but there really isn't any change in that story at this point. Questions about the viewer pipeline? A little thin right now, but as you can hear it tell, it's about to get bulked up again pretty soon. Okay, moving on. Next topic is inventory changes. And we've got Aura here to talk about what's coming there. Aura has been working her way through making inventory much, much more robust in a variety of ways. And this is a component of that project. So, Aura, you want to take the floor? Is Aura here?
Where's Aura?
I'm not seeing Aura.
She's not here. She's supposed to be here. It was such a long list, I didn't look.
So I can talk about one part of it if you want.
Okay, go for it while I ping Aura.
Basically, I know, Ed Worley, this is going to affect you and your support people probably the most, but one of the big problems that we've seen of late is people not being able to log in because of inventory type issues, and I'm sure you've seen your share of them too. We now have an ability to restructure the bloated folders to basically divide that into subfolders and such to be able to go ahead and resolve that login problem. We've only had a few people that we've done it to so far, but it's worked successfully each time so far, so it's pretty good.
Cool. We'll have to make a note to bring that up at our next support meeting next week.
People who have a giant flat inventory and are having trouble timing out or getting other errors during login, that transform will often fix it. Yes, right. So they can just contact support and say,
"Unflatten please, me.
My inventory is keeping me from logging in. Please unflatten me."
So that's available to non-premium as well, I assume?
Yes, I think so, right.
Coolness.
I guess the contact mechanisms are different, but the process is the same.
Willow, how recently? This basically became available in the past week or two.
Yeah, we've been testing it for quite a long time. We just recently pulled the trigger and told support that they could do it generally. So Aura should be here in a minute. But what's going on is Aura's going through and working through looking at lots of inventory reliability issues. One of the things that we've determined is that we've got too many paths over which inventory operations can take place right now, some of which really need to be deprecated and all the usage needs to move to better supported, more robust, newer mechanisms. So that's the process that she's beginning, and she's going to have a document to share with you and some other stuff.
And here she is.
Right on cue. Well, almost.
Right on floor. Let's see.
If you touch the little platform right behind you, you'll get a chair.
All right.
Oh, that works too.
I'm talented. Okay, so it sounded like you had introduced me. So I kind of missed which of the two change sets that I'm working on that we're talking about first.
Well, whichever order you want to do things in.
Okay, well, I believe that the message deprecation is the one that we're going to actually ship first. It's in line behind the changes that Ryder's been working on. I have the release notes for that. I'll get them in just a second. But what that is we have older messages that go through a UDP message system, and we've been slowly phasing those out and replacing them with TCP messages that are just better in a lot of ways for us and for you too. The ones that I have in my first pass for deprecation are ones that have already been deprecated in the viewer for some time. And I'm going to go ahead and turn off the backend support for those in the near future. So I have a viewer which does go ahead and get rid of those messages entirely. One sec. This is not the right one. Yes, it is. There we go. All right. So I'll need to make that document public. Sorry, one second. Okay. All right. So these are the ones that are being deprecated probably in, I'm going to guess, the next month. These are all messages regarding inventory that are being sent from the viewer to the simulator. And this goes through a list of the messages that are being deprecated, where they're called from, and what pieces of code they pertain to make it a little easier for you guys to test. Okay. And I need to find my other document one moment.
Now, what you're doing now is taking out the usages of these in the viewer code at this point, right?
Yeah, like I said, these messages have already they have basically two different ways that they can be accessed right now. They can go through the older UDP message system, or they can go through the newer load balanced HTTP system, which is more reliable for inventory transactions, which is what we'd like to be doing. Yes.
And at some point, we will be removing support for these from the UDP path on the simulator side as well, right?
Yes, I have that simulator code already ready to go. It'll obviously wait for the viewer to ship, and then that final deprecation will happen sometime shortly after that.
Right. So we will be putting when we get that simulator version up, we'll put it up on a DD first. We will let you know that it's there. You should go and test things, and let us know if we're going to be triggering problems with that we need to think about. But the goal is to give you the opportunity to do that testing, but then also give you the opportunity to fix the problem so that we're using the new messages on the new transports.
And for what it's worth, the new ones are actually, or the ones that are being deprecated first, are actually already in the release viewer and have been in use for between months and years, depending on which message we're talking about. You'll see in the code, if you look at it, that there's a if AIS enabled, then use the new AIS code. Otherwise, use the older message system. So, yeah. Okay. So should I go ahead and move on to the second project that I've been working on?
I don't have any questions. Hear any questions, so let's go.
All right. So the second one is more annoying and less immediately useful. It is I have decided to take on the inventory and viewer inventory files and begin the process of refactoring them. So the first phase that I've done for that is to actually split those into separate files. I have a document here which outlines what's in each file and where it was moved to. Basically, the purpose of this is to make the code more readable, easier to maintain, give us a base for adding more automated testing so that we can give you a better reliability of code, etc. But anyways, this first phase, all I'm doing, with the exception of renaming LL inventory object to LL inventory base and changing the file name, is moving the different functions to files where they're a little more tightly coupled to what their actual purpose is, to begin that refactoring process and to make it easier to do that future testing. So this is going to be a little bit annoying for third-party developers because it involves moving things, but at this point it should involve only moving things. There shouldn't be any code changes. That will happen in a later step. Yeah, I tried to make this as painless as possible, but those files were, they contained like 10 or 15 different notions in them, which makes it nearly impossible to get good testing in place for them. It makes it slower to recompile if you make changes to them because it's touching more things, etc. So, yeah.
The Aura has tried to do this in a way that minimizes the pain, even while acknowledging that we're going to cause some pain. So this first set of changes represents a point you should try to merge to and get everything working again, so that when we actually start changing the code inside those files, you'll have a working base from which to do those merges. If we were to both split the code into multiple files and make changes to it at the same time, we understand that we'd be creating a real nightmare scenario for anybody trying to merge things. So it's really important that you watch this one, and when this set of changes works its way through, that's why we're giving you plenty of heads up about it. You get merged to that, you get synced up with that, you get things working on that basis, along with whatever your local changes are. And we're trying not to make changes to the names yet. We may do that as part of the next round. Other than that one change that renames the base class.
Yeah, Latif, that's exactly the kind of thing that I'm hoping to do in the future. Once we have this file where I can actually put a test around things, that will mean that I can write tests, then make changes to the code, make sure that nothing's broken, because the test should still work if everything's done correctly. And it'll just give us a higher degree of confidence in making things more consistent and easier to deal with. And that's why I'm choosing to go ahead and bite the bullet and do this. Anyhow, I think that's all I have, Oz.
Okay. One other heads up. Another thing that Aura will be working on in the future is we're going to be, once we've got some of these older messages properly deprecated, is we're going to be putting in some checks on the server side, most of which are in our code on the viewer side now, but which we want to make sure they can't happen. So, for example, right now we have found users who have multiple copies of folders that there should only ever be one of. And that causes a variety of problems. And so we're going to, once we've narrowed the number of code paths we have to put them on, we're going to be adding some of those integrity checks to the operations that take place through the newer inventory APIs to prevent viewers that are either maliciously or unintentionally causing things to happen in inventory that we don't expect to ever see. So that will mean adding some error handling paths in the viewer and so forth. But that is one of the folders that we expect to put some guards on. Yeah, another one is trash. We have seen users that have multiple trash folders and multiple cough folders, and both of those cause problems.
Please don't do that. It makes me cry.
You should not be able to do that. And someday you will not be able to. Yes, don't make Aura cry. I need Aura. So, that's sort of, you know, the next couple of phases, we're giving you plenty of heads up on that, on the inventory reliability improvements. We're serious about making this work better, and we're devoting a lot of time and attention to it. So, I have an item on here for the status RSS feed change. I'm trying to remember. Did we ever actually give you the new feed to test against, and have you been doing it? Because what we're going to do is change the feed to RSS version 2 from version 1. Anybody remember? Because we're going to throw the switch on that stuff pretty soon. It's the RSS feed is used to detect status support, you know, status blog posts.
The good status page.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, I will be posting a note about that to the announce list and open source dev list real soon now. And I think that is, in fact, all of the topics I had updates for today. So the floor is open.
I guess the only thing I had was for Izzy, and that was something that Worley had contacted him about. I just wanted to make sure he got that from Worley.
Was it via support case or an IM? Or
he got fixed? Cool. Worley, look, yeah. Don't worry about it. Izzy got taken care of.
Oh, no problem. I was just figuring the last case I did for Worley was a few weeks ago. That's why I was wondering, because between my vacation and training in New Linden, I haven't actually been in the mines lately.
Yeah, so support fixing them up, all's good.
Awesome.
I don't think we have ETA. We'll be putting out the viewer changes first. Those will come out behind the HTTP changes. So you'll have plenty of chance to see them. And then sometime after that's in viewer release, we'll start putting the server changes up on AGNI, on Aditi. Sorry. And how quickly we'll go depends on how severe and widespread any problems that are found are.
Oz, let me give you a 4x4 to hit him with.
That's only on the third offense.
Can we stop telling people who have a really huge inventory and can't log in to clear their cache?
It's amazingly counterproductive.
We do.
Just a complete aside to everything else.
Grumpity, for the past 3 years, that's what we've been telling people. Stop clearing your cache.
Yeah, and the only time we tell them to clear their cache is after running a particular kind of transformer to that, frankly, they have to then.
Yeah. But once in a while, we still tell people to clear their cache when we've already diagnosed that the problem is their inventory is too large.
No, never. Never, not once. Now, we might do a transform that we know doesn't work and then have them do it, but that's different.
Not really that the inventory is too large, it's that it's too large in the wrong place.
Yeah, right.
In the place where clearing cache doesn't help.
You'd be amazed at the number of people saying, oh, I'm lagging, so I'm going to clear my cache and relog. Because they're lagging.
Yeah, well, if the problem is that their inventory is too big and too flat, then we now have a standard supported way of dealing with that. And we have seen some, in the course of developing this change, we have seen some really amazing ones. Tens of thousands of items all in one giant flat top level inventory.
As in not nested, G, all in one folder, not in subfolders.
Yeah, like 150,000 items in the top level folder and 5,000 folders.
But why would that cause login issues? I don't understand.
Well, suffice to say that it does. Let's...
On that note, anything else? All right. I'm going to run away.
Any other topics for the day?
Nothing for me, actually. Take care, Grumpity. That was Grumpy that was running away, wasn't it?
It was. Yes. She came in from being out sick to attend this meeting.
Dedication.
Yes, have a wonderful weekend, everybody.
I'm not going anywhere yet. Yes, I'm working through Snapshot Naran. At this point, the main issue is the freeze world feature. Thank you, Aura. Okay. The other thing about that one, Naran, actually, if you could please rename the repository you've been putting those things in so that it has a shorter name, because on our build systems, the path name gets too long and the Windows builds fail. Not sure exactly what the limit is that will survive, but, you know, make it something normal. Yeah, it's, well, what can I say? Don't get me started on Windows. I'm not going to go there. But Yeah, it. Yeah, just change it to the, you know, the storm and the issue number or something. And let it go at that. Right. Because what ends up happening is it's not just the name you pick. That name gets combined with a couple other things in constructing the path names for the build in the build server so that various builds don't step on each other. And yeah, so the icon loading thing, that's a great topic. I've been waiting for somebody to come up with a proposed fix. Yeah, by all means, go ahead, Naren. Right. Yes, that's what I meant. But do we? Okay. A question about that. Do those not get? Oh, so the little ones over in the sidebar anyway. So yeah, never mind. Forget it. So what's the trick? Well, if nothing else, it seems as though those ought to be really small unless what we're doing is dynamically scaling a big image into a teeny tiny square. Please tell me we're not doing that.
You're doing that, Oz. You're doing that. You can't really do anything about it unless you want to actually do server, like, magic to create more copies of the image.
Well, we could do it once. We could scale it once when we've downloaded it and just keep a copy around to... And then discard the... Yeah, so then discard the original.
It's just weak. No time. And yeah, really, that's always fun.
What format are we using for those images?
It's JPEG 2000, which then decodes to a raw OpenGL image.
Oh, great. And we tell people not to use big images on their clothing. Okay. Well,
I love that so voice. It just loves to crash all the time when I'm actually using it.
Well, if nothing else...
It would fix it if you also made it discard when they're not being viewed.
If we can get them down to 4K a piece, we don't even care if they don't get discarded when they're not being viewed. Relative to what's going on inside the view window, it won't be significant.
But fixing discarding is a problem because of how UI images work. The viewer expects them to always be there. If you start discarding them, then you crash.
Yeah.
I've tried to do it that way, and it just turns into endless pain. And yeah, not enough alcohol in time.
Okay. So, well, I'd really love to see that fix. I don't know what the company would think of me offering people booze. We'll have to get back to you on that.
Hey, Oz, did you send out a t-shirt?
I haven't been looking. About half the people here are not rendering for me because rendering as
we're jelly babies,
colorful blobs. No, we're very carefully not using that word.
I don't know how to break it to you, but they're going to be called jelly babies.
As long as they're not called that in our documentation, it's okay.
I need to think of a different shape for the jelly babies now. Maybe jelly bean shapes. Or snowmen. I know, I'll just replace one that's a jelly baby with a picture of Doge.
One of the things that we're going to do before we put that out as a release candidate is review the intensity of the colors again. I may tone them down even further than they are now. Oh, I'll have to hunt that down. Thank you, Whirly. The idea is to make them less prominent, not more prominent. Right now, the messages that users get about how many people are or are not rendering them are based only on how many people running the project viewer are or are not rendering them. So it would be good if we got that reporting code into all the viewers as quickly as possible. Yes, well, there are translation files for a reason, Duran. You can replace the strings with anything you want. Well, Cinder, I'm sure you'll be able to figure it out how to make it functionally equivalent. Well, there's an option to make it infinite because, you know, you guys always want there to be options for everything. No, we want it to be true that if you've got a supercomputer to do the rendering with, you shouldn't have to turn it off. The thing is, I really want to emphasize this, and I hope that people understand it. We're not trying to create a standard for what is good. What we're trying to do is inform people about what effect they're having and allow them to control the impact other people have on them. And then let things sort themselves out. If everybody you hang out with has super high-end video cards and you know, giant multi-core systems that can do all the rendering in the world and have never run out of memory, then you can all bling yourselves out to your heart's content, and it'll be fine. It'll be just great. You won't be hurting anybody. The default number varies based on your GPU, ultimately. It depends on whether on the default setting for what your graphics level is. So if you're ultra, I think the default is 300,000. If or maybe that's one step down, and ultra is unlimited. We recently increased the lowest one for people on really low end GPUs up to, I think the new value is 35,000. Yeah, we changed them on the last build. We made it high enough that all the library avatars fully render, even for the lowest one. But actually, you know, having used that, it that's still a very, very, very protective value. And you know, a bunch of you here are way over that. I mean, I've got mine set at around 100,000 now, and I'm still getting a perfectly reasonable frame rate. And you know, maybe a quarter of the people here are derendered. For mid and mid upper range systems, it's something like that. So yeah, so if that's the way you feel, Niran, the goal is that you'll be able to set it that way, and that's what you'll get. But other people have their own choices to make. In the latest build, we redid it so that it's two columns now instead of one. It's wider and shorter, so it fits on laptop screens again. But it does show everything on one page. Yeah. Well, it's the advanced floater, yeah. It's always been a separate floater. I don't ask why questions, answer why questions about UI. I don't get to make those calls, so. Well, Niran, if we didn't leave you floaters to redo, I think you'd be unhappy.
Gotta give you something to complain about.
okay. It's fine. I don't much care if the floaters don't get merged. I hope the underlying functionality gets merged. I've got another meeting to go to, folks. So I need to cut out. I will see you all in 2 weeks.
Thanks, Hans. Thanks, Ryder. Poof.
Yay. Hi, Billy. But also, Cinder. Cinder, but why do you have this?
Just why?
Oh my god, it rotates. It rotates.
Oh my god. Yes.
Man,